draw 6. Okay, so now he's 24-24. Now we can throw it. Kazul's Fury. Face. Sacrifice Doggo.
Nice!
Today, we're answering an age-old question. Who flinged the dogs out, everybody? Was it Mordenkainen or was it Kazul? Well, I'm gonna answer that. Was both of them, because you need both cards, of course. We're checking out a new card from D&D called Mordenkainen, of course. Mordenkainen. He has a plus ability. You draw two cards, put a card from your hand onto the bottom of your library. Not what we're going for here. -2. Create a blue dog illusion creature token with... This creature's power and toughness are each equal to twice the number of cards in your hand. So all you need to do is have 10 cards in hand. Fling this with Kazul's Fury and you win. So how are we going to set that up? It's actually not that difficult, honestly. Not that difficult. So first of all, we need Wizard Class because we need to have no maximum hand size while we're setting this up. So that's a given. Then we just need to draw cards. So essentially everything else is a way of drawing cards or bouncing things so that we get more time to draw more cards. Essentially the entire deck. So we have everything which draws discards. We have Cathartic Reunion, which is of course the best one because when you copy this, you draw 6 cards, but you only lose 2. So you essentially draw 4 cards and that's very good. And if you have Seagate Stormcaller with Cathartic Reunion, that's just insane because you copy it so many times. So Cathartic Reunion, 3 low possibilities, and Tormenting Voice. And then we have everything which copies. The best ones being Seagate Stormcaller. Probably it is the best one in this deck because you get a body on the board which can block and do other things with. We have Dual Strike and we have Teach by Example to copy. We have Into the Royal and Brazen Borrowed to stay alive, and of course Brazen Borrowed doubles down at some kind of damage dealer sometimes. Storm's Wrath to clear the board. Easy peasy. Dog fling squeeze.
Who fling the dogs out?
My throat. Okay, keep this. It's good out. Good out, gotta say. Lead off with Le Wizard Class. Le Wizard Class. Of course. Of course, the Wizard Class. Man, my head. It's getting cut out of the picture. I don't like it. In this case, I think we just go. Do we go through the possibilities or do we put down. I think we just put down this as well. For the time beyond. And then probably just level up this level 2. I think that's gonna be good. Opting. I think, like, people are sleeping on the Wizard Class overall. I gotta say, I mean, it's kind of needed in this deck. Because we need the maximum hand size to get big dogs. But it's a good card, honestly. Wizard Class. 10 out of 10, good card, okay. Midnight Clock, main. What a control deck, okay. We solve that. I think this time, what we're gonna do, don't really have that much we can do actually. We can throw the possibilities and possibly get something else, but we have so many cards which copy, but only one thing to copy. So I think we'd rather do this, then maybe we bounce the Midnight Clock to slow him down a little bit, because we are not really doing anything this time. And I think that he's gonna do a big play if we don't do this. I think that's gonna happen. Okay. Back to Le Hand. And Lava Lamp is gonna play that Midnight Clock again. Question. What a piccolo! You're gonna play that again! Oh, no. No, we didn't! Do we clear that up now? Or do we wait? That's the question. Do we wait? We could draw a lot. No, I don't think we just clear. I mean, I don't think he has that many creatures. It's just a lot of enchantments, some artifacts, not that many creatures. So this is good. It's good stuff. And also if we draw a land next time, we can Mordenkainen. Okay. Midnight Clock. This is what I think we will do. So lead off with this. Put down you. Thrill of possible ATs. Throwing away. Probably Dual Strike at this point. I don't think we're gonna have time to foretell that anyways. So, draw a couple of cards. Land! Please! Yes! Thank you! Thank you! And then, let's bounce it again. Let's bounce it again. To the hand you go, sir. Up to the hand. And here we have some pretty nice draw action there, gotta say. Lava Lamp is gonna be playing at midnight clock for the third time. Might be doing that. He's still waiting on his fifth land there. Oof. Oh, he needs the malice. He needs to play the midnight clock again. But it's getting a little bit silly also. He doesn't want to do. As long as it's not your turn, Belgos Mordcast. Sure. Sure. We could go Mordenkainen now, actually. I think it's actually time to just do that. Mordenkainen, get the dog. And it's not that big yet. It's not that big. I think next turn, when we play all our copy spells in a row here, it's gonna be decently sized. Decently sized, gotta say. Let's see, how much does it cost if we want to get the triple from this? So it's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 if we want to do that. So we have 5, 6, 7. So we need two more manas if we want to do that. Not my Mordenkainen, no! But we have the dog. That's all we need, essentially. From the Mordenkainen. Don't unsummon my dog. Don't you dare unsummon it. Lava Lamp, don't you dare. Okay, Portable Hole, no! My dog! Oh, my doggo! It did use two cards, though. To get rid of essentially one card of mine. So that's nice. I think in this case, what we're gonna do here, we're gonna play Stormcaller. For two. Then we're gonna teach him by example. We're gonna double copy this. Ba-dum, ba-dum. And then Tormenting Voice, of course, because this is gonna get copied twice now. Throw away the land. Get six cards in hand. Kinda nice. And there's the Cathartic Reunion. That's probably gonna be needed, I think. No attacks. Now we can get back more than Kinda also. Also, with Brazen Borrower. That's kinda nice. We don't have any more copy spells, though. We wasted all of them. All that thing. Now that we drew Cathartic Reunion, would have been so much better if I had Cathartic Reunion with all that. That would have been amazing. Okay. Let's see here. Can we do something cooler? We can Tormenting Voice. Away a Tormenting Voice, I think. Just to lead off it. We kind of want to save these. We want to find a copy spell. Yes, there's the copy. This girl. And teach by example. Noise. And Cathartic Reunion. Probably shipping this. And probably the Cathartic. Man, I love the Cathartic. But I'm gonna draw so many cards with this. 9 cards, I mean. To be exact. To be intact is what I was about to say. It's not the correct wordage there. I know. Possible snarl. Yeah, no attacks. I think we got it now. We can just return the Banishing Light and then fling the Mordenkainen dog. He's still on 4 lands! Lava Lamp, how is this possible in your control deck? Do you always play Midnight Clock or rely on that, maybe? There, it's the 5th land for Lava Lamp. Oh, how he has worked for that 5th land! Oh, the battle and the struggles and the everything for that 5th land, sure. Let's see here. First of all, we need the Benoons. This Banishing Light here. Get our Mordenkainen back. Then we have to see how big is this dog. 20, so we need to be even bigger than that. So we need to Dual Strike first. Dual Strike. Cathartic Reunion. How many cards left? 21. It's fine. What do we throw away? Into the Royal and Wizard Class. Brum, brum. Draw 6. Okay, so now he's 24. Now we can throw it. Kazul's Fury. Face. Sacrifice Doggo. Nice! Game just started. Game just started. We straight into the gamer. Put down this. I'm not gonna show on the Raven Island. I would be giving away too much information, I think. I think also, what can I would speak of the heavens? But think about it. If you have green, Wait, can you have a green-white untapped... No, we can't in standard. It's impossible to have a green-white land which is not untapped. Because I'm thinking you could activate this on your turn 2. There is... If you play the land, which gives you 2 HP, and you could have a green-white land. And then you could play the green card. Which... I guess there are actually ways of... Do... No? Is there any ways of getting this off on turn 2? Man. There's a green card which gives something, first you gain 2 life, and then a creature gets plus X, where X is the amount of life you gain this turn. So that essentially doubles with Speak of the Heavens, you get 4 from it. But if you have a life in land, that would be, like 8, because this is lifelink. So that would be amazing, amazing. In this case, I think we just keep up the Brazen Borrower and the Into the Royal. We kind of want to go for 4 manas, do a big draw player. Hornet 2, 4, 5. Reading skills. Amazing. Okay, sure. Let's max in. And 16, he's up 22. He has nothing. I'm kind of feeling Into the Royal or Brazen Borrow on that Orator, maybe. Yeah, let's return that Orator. Let's return. So he has to play him again. And in this case, I think go red. Can't really do anything extra. We kind of want to play the Brazen Borrower. So luckily I played this instead of this. It's not because I'm a genius. You might be thinking, Chris, you're a genius. Actually, you probably are not thinking that, but sure. Okay. This is kind of a decent card, I've come to realize. Like, you put a plus card on anything whenever you attack. So... And you untap it, so 2 good abilities on this, and you get to learn. Kinda good. Kinda like that card. Badank, sure. And a Brazen Borrower, so that he doesn't gain too many life points. That would be horrible. Smack him, just to keep him not, you know, from going off completely. From not ruining us completely. And then see get Stormcaller. Unfortunately, we can't block this guy now. Let's get this. Oh, I mean, we can block him. But we can't kill him. So we do this, and let's see here. Tormenting Voice. Throw away the island or the River Glide. I mean, if we draw into another Frostball Stone, actually, it might be better to have the island. Just thinking that might be the case, okay? Dual Strike plus Thrill. That's kind of nice. We need the Wizard class down first, though. Okay, Hornet, 2-4, 2-5. Yep, that's just one of those days. One of those days, huh? Do we block to save our life total? Nah, I think he's gonna come in with this then next time, so let's not do that. And now we can actually block if we do this. Seagate, Oracle. Fill of possibilities. Throw away the island. Couple of cards. Nice. And then down with this, and down with this. Smack him in the air. Ooh, pop, 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 pop. So he's not going off with the Speak of the Heaven. And this is really good. I like this card. Can we somehow get this into a deck, I'm thinking? With Vorinclex, you can double the counters. Just throwing things out there. I think Vorinclex with Sparring Regimen. And you can play this with the Druid. No, not Druid class. Ranger class. Frack. Frack pacifism. I like it. Oh. Still put the plus counter on that. Interesting. Because that dies. Sure. We're down to 7 though. We're down low. Down freaking low now. But now I think is when we make our comeback here. Draw a couple of cards. And do we... We could bounce this now, in case he has a life... No, it's fine. We smack him with this. Smack him with this. Let's see here. Play a River Glide Pathway. And just keep up the Into the Royal. On the Speak of the Heavens, when he comes crashing in there. Inevitably. 5 manas. Another sparring regiment. What did he pick up with this, though? We didn't see anything. Did he not have a car to pick up with it? Because that would be savage. He just plays this. Zero lessons. Sparring regiment. Not the best name. Beginning with upkeep, put a plus count on each good you control. Ah, okay. And Speaker of the Havans, plus counter on him. And then he goes back to the hand to sleep. Oh! Oh, gotta sleep, buddy, gotta sleep. Okay, so now with Dual Strike, surely. Dual Strike. Cathartic Reunion. Throw away. Yeah, Thrill and Tormenting, probably. And draw a lot of cards. Ooh, we did draw land. Nice. And we got into the Royal. So we can play another Wizard class, sure. Do that. And attack with Brazen Borrower. We're not killing him, but we're preventing him from getting the 27 HP. Okay. Put a plus counter on each other creature, but it didn't control any other creatures. Ornette. 2, 5. Or nail it, everybody. Freaking nail it. Why is this combination of the numbers so difficult to say? I don't know. 2-5-4. Okay, I gotta quit that. We gotta go and check out. Check out. This meme gets upvoted every time I don't post a video. Chris didn't post a video today because all his games were against Jason Dennis! Freaking Jason Dennis! Blocking us all from realizing our potential or something. Okay. Do we now return the Victory Envoy? Okay, plus counter on that girl. And, it costs so much anyways. He's not gonna be able to play it again. Return it. Okay, we have our Murdenkainens ready to go now. I kind of want to draw a card also. Because if we want to draw into a land, and play Mordenkainen. That would be amazing. So we Cathartic, I think, first. Cathartic away a Tormenting and a Thrill. Without copying. Just to find the land. Which we did, in a way. But not in the way I wanted to find it. No. Okay, could Seagate Oracle double bounce? And played land. Yeah, we'll do that. Seagate. Double bounce. Bounce you. Bounce you. Whoop, whoop. None of these creatures have haste anyway, so. Let's bounce everything. And next turn, we'll be able to do our business. Takes a while to set up with this deck, I know. Takes a little bit of time. A little bit. Ornette, though. He has been a little bit set back here by the cards, gotta say. Mostly everything in hand at this point. Not too much on the board except the regimen, which I praised a lot. That's why I didn't want to bounce it, because then he would learn again. He would learn his lesson if I bounce this. I didn't want to do it. 7 manas. Victory's Envoy. Angel of Vitality. Okay. Angel of Vitality. Victor's Envoy. No? Speaker down. And pass the turn. So now I mean we got almost everything we needed, right? Main. That's one more lava. It's fine, it's fine. It's always. I want one more mana with this deck, I feel like.
Faithful hound.
My faithful hound. Okay, smack in. He cannot block with the Angel of Vitality. He wants it, but he just takes it. Fine. I think we foretell this also. Fell. Put down this tap, because we only need one of them. And that's good. He's gonna smack Mordenkainen down to one. No, down to zero, because he has the sparring regimen. But that's fine, we have the doggo now, so we don't need it. Next time we dual strike Cathartic and draw from the Wizard class and Kazul's Fury. If we can do all that, I think we can. Puerto Maletus, Maletus. Victor's envoy, maybe. And just smack him with Angel. He's a little bit low, though. Little bit low, okay. Angel coming in from Mordenkainen, surely. Surely that has to happen. Else I create another Doggo. No, just the base. I mean, I am kind of low, though. Down to 4.
Okay.
So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna Dual Strike. Cathartic Reunion. Don't need the Mordenkainen, we have one already, so. Chip this. Draw a lot of cards. We can draw from this also. So draw from this. 16. Big dog! Oh! And we can draw one more from this.
Your tiny mind could
put this back. 24, 24. And... Ma! Sma! Kadam! Smakadunk! Smakadink! A nice hand, and we go first.
Yes! 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 Nice! 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 Nice!
A good feeling. Good feeling about this, okay? Submit one. Wizard class. Down in the ground. Road Rash. It's gonna play. Hopefully not mono red aggro, no? Same old.
Same as always, I hear, okay? Fine.
Tormenting voice. Shipping the tormenting voice. Nah. Didn't find lander. Find another land soon. We have a cathartic, so. Chances of not hitting a land would be low, I think, at this point. Low. If we hit a land next turn, we'll just level this up to level 2. Awesome. Road Rash. 2 manas. Passion the Raider. Exact same play, I think, as last game. Yep. Yes. This is a very popular deck, gotta say. Life gain deck just. It's so popular. Everybody loves it. Do we just return with Brazenbar? I think we do. We also do the same play as last game. Except now we can't play Brazenbar because we don't have 2 blue. Okay? Righteous Valkyrie. Sure. I think him gaining 1 life there and 1 life there is fine. I think we just return this guy for the time being. He's gonna play it again next turn and hopefully we can have Storm's Wrath. He's bored then. That'd be nice. We're going to red though. We don't. We can level up this, so let's do that. Level up, find land. No. No land. It's fine. Fine, we need a lot of cards in hand anyways, right? So it's not a problem. Okay. 24. We need him to not get the 27 here. Hopefully. Just have a color dead. Land? Yeah, crack tap land. Rack and he's gonna level up. Oh no! This is horrible! We cannot. Rack. Because this is gonna. Horrible circumstance. Missing on lands 2 turns in a row. No! I guess we have Brazen Morwen. So we can always maybe do some tricks in us with that. To save us from him going up to 27. Might not have anything to follow up the Riders Valkyrie. Possibility. Let's see here. This is a cleric, so this will give him 3 life with this. So we can't let him have that. Because now we will only go up to 26. With the Speak of the Heavens. Yep. No, we will go up to 27 with this, but it's fine, because we're gonna Storm's Wrath everything away. Is this the exact same guy we played last? I don't think so. I think he just plays the exact same deck. Okay. An Angel. Fine. Storm's Wrath. Clear those guys up a little bit. Was put a snarl down on the ground. Man, missing on lands here. 2 turns in a row. Oof. I think, this is really good now. That's the unfortunate part. Righteous Valkyrie.
Okay.
So you have 2 of them. No? Aspirant though. Anything is almost good enough now. For him. Okay, well we'll try to survive for a while here. Put down this. Cathartic Reunion. Throw away these 2 maybe? hopefully find a land in 6 cards. We do. Now we kind of hit a land pocket, maybe? Okay, we're fine. We have an inter roll, so we can just bounce the Righteous Valkyrie when it comes sharding in there. And kill the Aspirant. So that's good. It's really good. Heliod Sun Crown. Sure. And... okay. Gets that guy lifelink. It's a plus counter on that guy. That's perfect. Okay, well, you can go back to hand now. Oh, wait, I should have done this when he attacked in. I'm such an idiot. Because now we won't attack him with this. Oh, I messed up my own play. Now I cry. Okay, oh well. Mordenkainen. We are stabilizing, though. Despite my serious misplays. Okay, we kind of want him to get down lower if we can. In light paints. That would be nice. Road Rash. Why is Valkyrie coming down again? Surely. Or Mordenkainen getting schnooned there by an Elspeth Conqueror's death. It's one or the other. One or the other, I say. Man, this guy's good, honestly. I think when standard like rotates, he could like become a real thing, I think.
I'll be in my
a thing thing. Like a thing and a thing and a thing. And a thing. Okay. And the dog. Wow, that was expensive one though. Now Heliod is almost alive though. Or almost a creature, I mean. He's alive, but you know. Freaking creature. Freaking creature is stronger. You be that. You can be a creature, you can be anything.
I'll learn much from your failure.
I've learned much from your failures, because you always fail! It's a harsh teacher, but true to his word. Yes. Okay, Righteous Valkyrie. Okay, Heliod coming in there. He's not big enough yet, though. He can put a plus counter on him, though. Which is, there we go. Hate to see, but might happen. Okay, up 32. Put a plus counter on. Nice Valkyrie. Okay. And gives him lifelink even though he can't attack in. Good. Plus counter on that. That's too bad though. We can block this guy with the Seagate Stormcaller though. So not the biggest of dealios, I think. Oh, he doesn't even attack. Okay, that's good. That's very good. So we're gonna teach here by example. Cathartic Reunion. Don't wait these two. We need this to win, so. Nice! He's up to 14. He can get him to 16. I think we just killed the Righteous Valkyrie. That's the only thing that's really blocking us from... we can just bounce the Righteous Valkyrie when I think about it.
If I were you.
We just need it to not be there when he attacks in. That's the only thing we need. Right? I think so. Let's see here. 4, 5. Yeah, we just passed turn. Passed turn, we into the Royal, the Righteous Valkyrie, and maybe even the Banishing Light. And then we're fine, I think. Then we got him. Road Rash. Speak of the heavens. Sure. That's another 3 HP there. The plus counter, everything on that Valkyrie. Yes, perfect. Perfect. And Righteous Valkyrie and Heliod. Okay, gives that lifelink. Sure. And this is the thing he needs to smack in with. Ooh, buffing everything on the Valkyrie. 7. Okay. And then smash in. And kicker! Because we need to draw. Oh, wait, I should. No, I should not kick. Oh, it's fine. It's fine, I say. Whoop! Return to the hand. Nice, we draw a card. It doesn't replay it. Doesn't replay the Righteous Valkyrie. Interesting. In that case, draw 2. Put 1 card back. 1 card would be the Wizard class, which I don't think we need now. Now then, 16. Man, if we copy this, I think we might be able to win now. Okay, we'll do... How many lands do we have, though? Can we do this two times? 1, 2, 3, 4... Oh, we don't need to. Dual strike. 3 yellow possibilities. And throw away a river glide. Draw 4. Now if we copy a Kasul's Fury, will it be enough? Let's see here. 14, because we're gonna lose 2 cards. So 14, now it's only 28 if we do that. Frackers. It's fine. Because all we need to do now is... Could also bounce like everything he has. Can go in with both doggos. What a tricksy pickle. Glossa Seagate Oracle. Can we bounce everything he has so that we can go in with both dogs? I think we can do that, right? Because we have so many cop. We don't have any. We have Seagate Oracle. Okay, we can do that next turn, though. So we set up for doing that next turn. We put down this land. Do we play another Mordenkainen? Or do we just keep up Brazen Borrow? Well, we need Brazen Borrow to bounce next turn. Okay, if we do this, return... Here's what I think we do. We play this guy. Seagate. Haven't thought this through exactly if this is the best thing we can do. But I think it's fine. Okay, return his Heliod. And then we return his... what exactly? Speaker of the Heavens, probably, because that creates angels, right? Okay. Return these two. Wink, wink. And then we go in with the doggos. Because that would put him relatively low, and I don't think he wants to waste his creatures. He might want to. Probably has to, even. Because if he goes down too low, his creatures don't do anything. Nice! Then I think we set this up for next turn. And pass. Ooh! I think we're doing it! We're forcing him into blocks here. That's good. Let's go to the heavens. Helen Suncrown. Righteous Valkyrie. Yep. And that guy. Sure. Can create another dog here. Let's see. We fling a dog in the Righteous Valkyrie and attack in. I think that's just what we do now. I think we don't even fling face. Let's fling his creatures. Bloop. Kill this guy, because that's the only thing which is keeping him in the game, even. Create another doggo. And smack in. For big damage. Big damage. Now we can't use the Speaker of the Heavens. And we can just play another Mordenkainen, or we can do this. Which I should have done before attacking in. Because that would have been more damage, but I didn't do it. Oh, now we even have a Brazen Borrower. Okay, I just end the turn. Do we level up? No, end the turn. Oh! Too much to think about. My brain explode. No! Okay, Lumnok Aspirin. Fine. Still have the Brazen Borrower if he has some kind of tricks in us here. Can kill the dog somehow. Doesn't seem like he can. I think we got him. I think Bounce got us there. Unfortunately, we didn't fling a dog, but I think we can finish this off with a dog fling. I think we can do that. Okay. The plus counter on a creature you control. Speaker of the Heavens. Yes. And before end of his turn, can we...
Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. A special thank you, of course, to our latest members, which are... Not Autobahn, Esteban! Ether Walker, Ken K. It's a very hard name. Ken's got a hard name. And also, welcome back to Yet Alone. Thank you, everybody, so much. And see you tomorrow!
Hello, Daniel!
And you are...
It's me, the YouTube algorithm.
And what are you doing here?
I'm just here to take those views.
No, those are my views.
Oh, I can explain to you, senor. You see, you have subs 0% and non-subs 100%.
That's why you can take all your views.
I guess it's time that you check out a little thing down there.